One of your students sent a text to their parents. Did this happen?
If you're asking whether I responded to a student's question, yes.
And your answer incorporated the words of Jesus.
What were you thinking, Grace?
We're going to prove once and for all that God is dead.
Okay, well, that was a clip from God's Not Dead 2, one of the newest movies to hit theaters. But is it worth seeing? Here to tell us is our movie critic, Will Loper.
Good morning. Hi. So now, even going into this movie, knowing that it's a movie that preaches to the choir, it's about as off-key as you can get. You've got bad writing, one-dimensional characters. It's going to make this one faith-based film you want to avoid. So Melissa Joan Hart, she stars as a high school history teacher, Grace. When a student asks a question about the teachings of Jesus, Grace answers by quoting the Bible, and another student in class texts his parents about how offended he is, as we saw in that clip. Suddenly, Grace finds herself in court. Now, this is a movie that operates in black and white. You're either good or you're bad. Even worse, if you're bad, like a lawyer who wants to take Grace down, you act super sleazy and you have really bad facial hair. Or Ray Wise, who might as well be playing the devil himself as the prosecuting lawyer, who states outright that he just hates Christians and everything they stand for. So nothing is really realistic in this movie. It's got all these characters who are very, pretty much cardboard cutouts and cartoonish. It all sort of exists for the drama, and the drama is reminiscent of a cheesy made-for-TV movie. Now, the courtroom where the scenes where Grace is on trial, they're filled with witnesses and twists that the lawyers pretty much say things like, gotcha, and, oh, I didn't see that coming. But none of it really feels real. So with any luck, we won't have a God's Not Dead 3, or at least if we do, you know, hopefully they take a closer look and maybe a few more rewrites of the script.
So despite opening in more theaters, the movie actually made less than the original God's Not Dead.
Yes, the original, it made $9.2 million its opening weekend. And this sequel, it opened in 1,000 more theaters, made $1 million less. So, I mean, maybe people are starting to realize you can't just kind of coast. I think it's kind of has a built-in audience with these faith-based movies where they just sort of count on the audience coming, and I think they need to make them more quality.
Okay, so what did you rate this?
Yeah, this one, Sabrina the Teenage Witch, out of five. Of course, Melissa Joan Hart.
Yep. Okay.
There you go.
So let me check out your fingernails.
Not much left, yes.
Eye in the sky,
It was terrific, yes. So this one is kind of flying under the radar. It's kind of more of an independent release, but it just came to Madison. So if you're a person, yes, who bites their fingernails in tense situations like me, you might not have any by the end of the movie, and I certainly didn't. So the film stars Helen Mirren, Alan Rickman, and Aaron Paul, among others. They're all embarking on a drone operation in Kenya. It seems simple, capture two terrorists in a house. But over the course of the movie, new information keeps coming in. The house with the terrorists has two suicide vests. Now they're gonna blow the house up. But now there's a problem. A 9-year-old girl is selling bread right in the blast radius. So the problem becomes, do they blow up the house and knowingly kill that little girl, or do they let the suicide vests go, possibly kill up to 80 or more people later? So what is the right thing to do? So you're gonna be watching this movie, you're gonna make up your mind, and a minute later, you'll hear an argument from someone else, and you're gonna change your mind. And so the flip-flopping occurs throughout the movie, and you just don't know what to do. It's taut, it's intense, the performances and the writing are all top-notch, so.
Alan Rickman,
too. Yes.
Is this his last film?
Live action, last live action performance. He has a Alice in Wonderland sequel coming out still. But I gave it 4.5 out of 5 Alan Rickman's.
Ooh.
Yes, I loved it. It's terrific.
Go see it. That's amazing.
Yes.
All right, so what's new for next week?
Next week we have The Boss with Melissa McCarthy. She's selling Girl Scout cookies.
I just saw a preview for that.
It looks funny.
Okay, all right. Thank you very much, Will. Appreciate
thanks.
It.